We got some more capacitors today. I've been ordering lots of them. So I've got the parts to fix the power supply for the Apple 3. But mainly, what I'm interested in are the ones to fix this. The DCX-1600 cable control unit, also known by Sony as the CCU-1600. I've already got some of the capacitors replaced on it, on this board. This is the Chroma board. So it is going to be very integral to the camera working properly. But I didn't have any 47 microfarad caps. I replaced everything else that was on here, other than a couple 10 microfarads, which I did not have. These ones, these circuit boards like this, are actually pretty easy to work on compared to the newer ones. They're only single layer, so they actually work quite well with standard tools. So I'm going to start working on that now. Well, I've finished recapping this board. All new, shiny, nice Panasonic and Millicent caps. Here's the bag of old ones. Over 30. A lot of old designs had a lot of capacitors. So here's that board. This is the CC itself, and this board just goes and slides in, and then you tighten down a few screws, and then it's all set. I still have a couple caps to replace on here that I didn't have that I was waiting for, but there's that. And then there's a couple boards on the underside, and I'll show you those in a minute. Well, after recapping the processor and Chroma board, I decided I'm going to hook the system up. Got the camera control unit, power supply, camera. It is connected to my monitor. See if we get anything. Well, I do have a picture of sorts. The picture is all chroma. There is no luminance. So I'm gonna pull up the service manual, look at a few things, and see if I can track down where the problem might be before I go any further. Service manual up on my Mac here, and I think I might have found the problem. You see that right there, C1547 microfarad 16 volt. Well, it's not there. So, one in, and then we'll fire it up again. Okay, we're gonna power everything back up. Monitor's on, camera control unit is on, power supply's on, so the camera's on. All the controls are set to kind of center, so I'm not expecting extremely brilliant video, when I open up the iris, but ooh, we've got something. That's extremely blue. And also indoors. Make sure I'm on the right filter. Okay, changed filters there. And now some futzing with the picture. So I'm gonna pause it for a second and futz with white balance and pedestal and all that for a minute or two. Well, hi there. You can see me. It's actually producing quite a decent black and white picture now. Now color is still not right, but what I'm doing right now is messing with the white balance. But it's honestly the best picture I've gotten out of this thing in a long time, so it's a good start.